So we're here in Sudan on the motor yacht Elegante, and we are initiating our research study acoustically tracking sharks and rays around the Red Sea region of Sudan.
Ciao, sono Lisa, sono una biologa marina, ho studiato all'Università di Bologna, infatti vivo a Bologna in Italia. Per mia fortuna sono diventata una Cousteau Divers.
Merhabalar, ben Burçak Öztekin. Türkiye'den geliyorum bu Sudan'daki bilimsel araştırmaya. 2012 Kasım'dan beri Cousteau Divers üyesiyim. Ve şimdi 2013 Şubat'ında Sudan'daki köpek balıkları ve reylerle ilgili yapılan bilimsel araştırmaya bilimsel olmayan bir dalgıç olarak katılma imkanım oldu ve buradaki bilimsel araştırmayı gözlemleme imkanım oldu. Carried on fish surveys in certain dive sites that we've been to throughout this week, and I had a dive with him when he was conducting the fish survey at certain transects. He counted the fish, and meanwhile I filled in the Red Sea dialogue, so I counted as a novice diver what kind of sea animals we've come across in that certain area. Within the context of Divers Aware of Sharks program for the Red Sea, there is a survey for recreational divers that they can conduct during their dives to help scientists by providing them data on which kinds of sharks we see during our dives and what was the size and depth of them. So this is a very useful tool and very easy to fill in.
Tutti pensano che lo squalo sia una bestia cattiva e invece non è vero, perché quando abbiamo fatto le immersioni, anzi, era pieno di squali, ma erano talmente timidi che andavano via e per fare dei video era molto difficile.
One of the activities was the deployment of underwater fixed camera to conduct video surveys on which kinds of sharks we have here. So we deployed the camera several times, and we left them to record for several hours. I also helped her preparing the baits for the sharks.
Questi pesci sono stati pescati. Le parti più importanti che sono state prese sono state le pinne, gli otoliti e i muscoli. Nello stesso tempo sono state prese delle alghe oppure dei detriti, perché questi pesci si nutrono magari di queste alghe o di detriti, eccetera, e quindi attraverso queste analisi siamo in grado di sapere se questi pesci rimangono in questo reef oppure no.
The acoustic telemetry system has been used for about 30 years now. The technology evolved to incorporate what it is now, which is mainly passive acoustic telemetry. And passive acoustic telemetry involves a system of acoustic monitors such as this one. This is a Vemco VR2W. And this here is the hydrophone. This detects the acoustic signal. So here's the two main components of the basic system. We have the acoustic monitor and the acoustic transmitter. Each acoustic transmitter has a unique code. So once we implant this inside the shark or the ray, every 3 to 5 minutes, this emits a very high frequency, unique signal that can be decoded by the monitor. And at that time, if the monitor hears the tag, it records the time, the date, and the ID of the shark we've heard. Here in Sudan, we're asking very specific questions with the sharks. We're interested in their movements between the seas. This has very big implications for management of these species. With this technology, that's relatively cost effective, we can track these sharks now for 8 to 10 years based on the battery life. And that is very important in terms of tracking these large marine creatures because of their life history. They're extremely long lived animals. So in order to understand their movements, their behaviors, their migrations, we really need to track them over multiple years. And that way we can start to reveal a lot more about their life history.
In questa settimana io mi sono sentita molto bene perché mi è sembrato di far parte di qualcosa, di aver fatto qualcosa di utile, anche se è una piccola goccia nell'oceano, però l'ho fatto e spero di poterlo fare ancora.